Back in America, a young Brooklyn producer was about to redefine house for the 90s.
I listened to house music in 85 and 86, and at that time, house music could be anything. You know, it was like acid was house music. If it had an 808 beat and a more of electronic feel, it was house music. If it had a soulful vocal and a piano chords in it, that was house music, you know? And I liked that. I liked where I could jump around a little bit and go work with my moods. You know, I had many moods. I was happy one day, some days I was depressed. You know, by the time I was like 19 and well into making records, all that really didn't interest me. I still was like 19 and being rebellious. I didn't want to do music that was popular. I wanted to do music that was cool, underground, and, you know, represented me and, you know, the youth or whatever, you know. But I still thought I was making house music. I thought the track was done, needs one other element, something to put on top of it. Eventually I came across this record, the sample, it's Ecstasy, and I was just like, wow, that works with the track. But because of the time, because of the feel of the track, because it was a darker house record, which became techno or whatever, people were like, Ecstasy, you know, that's a drug record, that's a drug anthem. He means ecstasy, you know, the drug or whatever.
I don't think anybody expected for Joey to come out the way he did. And Energy Flash was some other shit. You know, it was really some other shit. It was like, I don't know how to explain it. It was a nice track, though. It still is today.
I think that broke the back of a lot of things. You know, it was just so different.
I think for me, it was hearing it for the first time about 7 in the morning at sort of as close as we can get to Stonehenge Krusty Festival thing, the Spiral Tribe. And I was just about, I was saying, right, I'm going to go to my tent now, I've had enough. And the sun was coming up and someone just started playing that. And I just thought, what the hell is that? And it just sounded like how I felt, do you know what I mean? This crazy sound. It was just, I can't believe this record. It's so hard and mad and, you know.
Great, brilliant records. I mean, I know people that even aren't into house music or techno have heard that and gone, what's this? This record's mad. And that's like 10 years after it was released.
Energy Flash redefined the limits of dance music. But its dark minimalism and brooding intensity was too much for the house scene.
I guess maybe I was disillusioned because, you know, I guess in England they just said, no, this is techno, son. You're making techno records and we're gonna call you techno. We're gonna sell your stuff, we're gonna like it, whatever. But as long as you have that techno label affixed to you, you know? But, you know, I thought I was making house music. You know, I just thought I was making house music, but with a different edge.